With us today is Chris Bruzzo. He is the CMO of EA. Chris, welcome to the show.
Thanks, Brian.
You know, it's actually great to spend time with you. I feel like an insider to the company, a little bit of a gaming geek, but also had the opportunity to work with you last year, actually.
Yeah. And,
but since then, there's been some big moves at the company. Andrew Wilson, the company's CEO, made some bold moves towards growth. You were part of that announcement, so congratulations.
Thanks.
Can you shed some light on what those moves were about and your role in it?
Sure. We believe the next 5 years will be more disruptive, more dynamic. We'll see more players come into gaming than in the last 45 years combined. So the moves we made this year were to better align to our future, which is a future driven by live services and into new models, new business models like subscription. So all of those factors went into some of the big moves that we made this year. For me, we've continued to integrate functions into what was marketing. So now marketing at EA includes all of the analytics and insights functions. So all the game analysts and researchers and insights folks, UX, the user experience researchers, et cetera. But just this year, we also added the publishing function. And that's our industry term for sales, for revenue responsibility. So now we have marketing, sales and revenue, and analytics all in a single team.
Well, that is pretty timely considering that keeping up with the customer, especially at the speed of their acceleration and evolution, it's got to be tough. I mean, in fact, most companies are struggling with that. It's a competitive advantage these days. The good news is that they're leaving a lot of data behind. They're casting a lot of signals. In my work, I've seen that companies have struggled even keeping up with those signals, but it seems that EA is approaching that a little bit differently. So share some of the insights of how you're approaching data and also how you're keeping up with insights at that speed.
Yeah, it's hard. There is an incredible amount of information that our players provide to us with just with their gameplay. And so we've made major investments in platforms and tools so that we can truly discern the patterns. What's causing players to spend more time in the game, less time in the game, leave the game entirely. And so the challenge becomes, how do you make sense of it in a way that allows you to still move at the speed of the player, make adjustments to the game experience that will make an impact before they leave. And so for us, we've worked very hard to embed our teams closely with our studios, our product teams. So our game analysts are sitting shoulder to shoulder with the game developers. It's a central function. So they get the expertise of data science and analytics and research, but they get the benefit of proximity to the men and women who are making the games. And that has proved to allow us to move much faster, collect insights, turn them back over to the product teams, and take action.
You know, I'd like to expand on that a little bit more because I think one of the weaknesses I also see within the organization is that data becomes a silo. So how are you sharing data and fostering collaboration across the organization?
Yeah, it took a really concerted effort. I mean, we, 5 years ago, made a decision to centralize to a single data platform, centralize to a single digital platform. And for EA, one of the things that makes us unique is that we've centralized to a single game engine as well. And so as a result, whether you're a game developer in Stockholm, Sweden, or in Vancouver, British Columbia, you have access to this robust and constantly improving set of platforms and tools for making sense of data, but also sharing work that's been done all over the world by other EA employees. And so for us, getting to a single data platform and then turning over the really democratizing access to that data and the ability to take action from the insights that come from that data all the way down to the team level has been the key, but I won't tell you it's easy.
I'd imagine so, which is probably why it's a competitive advantage right now. It's a huge competitive advantage. Speaking of which, the most advanced companies in digital transformation are also looking at the role of marketing. What is marketing today and what could it be? And they're using it as a strategic driver for business growth. So I'm curious to hear from your role and also the role of marketing in general, how you see it evolving at EA.
Yeah. I've said now for a few years that marketing is coming apart. But that's not a bad thing because we get to put it back together in a different way. How do we get closer to the business, closer to setting business strategy? For us, we've continued to integrate more and more functions into marketing so that we can constantly close the gap between what we make and the messages we create and the players and their experience. So we added sales, revenue, publishing responsibilities into marketing, just like we moved analytics and insights into marketing. And putting them together in that way really makes us dangerous when it comes to business strategy. So we are right at the table there talking about how emerging technologies like streaming and emerging business models like subscription are going to fundamentally change the way game companies engage with players.
And this is really making marketing a true C-suite function. And right. Curious to hear how you're tying metrics between growth and speaking the language of the C-suite.
Yeah. Well, one of the most important things I did when I arrived at EA 4 years ago was pick up on some great work that was started around player engagement. And we can talk about that as consumer engagement. It's really easy for companies to focus on financial metrics, units sold or revenue growth. But for many companies, including EA, putting the customer at the center and measuring it at the highest level is critically important to changing the way we operate. So we created a single set of core player metrics at EA that measure a player's engagement, their number of session days, the number of players playing, their net promoter score for the game, and their spend. And the collection of those things is actually what nets growth for us, as opposed to just thinking about units.
Experience and engagement, that's huge. Yeah. And we also live in an era of AI and machine learning. So I'd love to hear your thoughts on how you're segmenting audiences to keep up with those expectations for experiences and engagement.
Yeah, that's the issue, is keeping up. When you put the players at the center, your consumers at the center, you want to be where they are. But to be where they are means to be in so many places now. Channels that our players are engaging with change really rapidly. So we think more about customer sets than we do about channels. And we want to follow our customers wherever they are. But the complexity of that is a lot to manage. So automation, AI, machine learning allows us to be relevant, to have the right message in the right channel without using a human to make every single one of those version changes, to hand select what content each player will see in each location. Instead, we can take this constant learning mechanism and be automating this at with speed what we show a player and measuring whether it generates more engagement or less engagement.
You know, I love it because I once heard you say or talk about the relationship between data and creativity, and I can hear it in your responses and also the enthusiasm that you have. I'd love for you to share with me and us your thoughts on the connection between data and creativity and what that looks like moving forward.
Yeah, we believe that data informs our communication strategy. It doesn't drive it, it doesn't dictate, it doesn't prescribe, it informs. And when we say data, we mean listening to players in all the ways that we can listen to them. Sometimes that's a conversation like this. A lot of times that's observing their behaviors, you know, in the game. And so for us, we use that to better understand what will be on target, what will be relevant to players. But we also use it to measure our success. So if we're doing things and they're working, we can do more of those things. And it takes us less time to replicate that. That creates space. If there's space for us to be well planned, to have systems that automate the delivery of messaging, then we open time, dollars, just brain space for our professionals, our creative people, to try new things. When we use data to improve our effectiveness, we actually give ourselves permission to go after the unknown, because we're we're confident that most of what we're doing and the resources we're spending are working.
Chris, I have to tell you that I'm impressed. The focus that you're taking, not just on growth, but player centricity and the relationship with new technology to get closer to players is impressive. It's making you more engaging, more experiential, but also dangerous. Chris, thanks for being on the show.
Thanks a lot.